completed my first Uber Eats order. And so now I know I'm never picking up another Crumbl cookie order again.
I've never seen a payout that high.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another delivery vlog. It is Thursday. It is raining today. I don't know if you could tell on the windows, but yeah, I got my hood on just in case. And if you checked out my vlog, you see that I signed up for Uber Eats and I got approved and everything. I'm so excited. So I just accepted my first Uber Eats order. So I'll put it up here. It's about $10 for, I think it's like 7-8 miles or so. So I'm actually heading over to the restaurant now. It's Houlihan's. So let's go. There's 3 items. So let's head over. I've definitely already been getting way more orders coming in on Uber Eats than I have with DoorDash. Like they're a little bit more consistent. So I've already noticed that. So that's good. More options to make more money. So anyways, let's just head over. It's navigating me now to the restaurant. Let's go. So I was on my way, but it seemed like the GPS froze. So I'm looking at the GPS to see where I'm supposed to turn because it has the map and where my location is. But it's like not updating. So I'm thinking I'm waiting to turn because it's still showing that my turn's not coming up. But then the directions are telling me otherwise. Then the image is showing me, and now it's telling me like I have to make. Oh my God. All right, Uber, you already done messed me up. So now it's taking me an alternative route. Have the greatest first impression. Uber, get it together, GPS.
Swipe up for order details and pickup notes from the business. Once you have the order, check its contents if possible.
Okay. They got out loud instructions. Okay, so it says swipe up. Okay. So now we see her order. So let me just click on it. Okay, so I'm just going to go in. And then once I get the order, then I'm going to click verify order. Alright, so let's go get it. Okay. So the guy in there had me swipe that I confirmed the order. So I kind of learned while I was in there. So you click confirm order and then you swipe order was picked up. So there's a click and a swipe that you do when you're picking up an order for Uber Eats. Okay, so now it's already navigating me to her place. First floor, leave at door. Please leave the food the closest to the front door as possible. The closest to the front door as possible. Not sure exactly what that means. See how that looks like. Okay, so let's go. Yeah, the customer is 11 minutes away, by the way, so, yeah.
Drop off on the right. Jackie R says, leave a door. First floor, please leave the food the closest to the front door as possible.
So that order was complete. Woo-hoo! There's the money for that. So yeah, I've completed my first Uber Eats order. So learning experience. I actually do like how they have like the voice that speaks to you to tell you what the next steps that you have to do are in the app. That makes it very helpful for your first order. So that was really cool. Yeah, so they probably won't do that again, I'm guessing. Now, it's like, you should probably know how it goes. There was actually another order that was like coming through to accept or not, but it was like $12 for like 16 miles. And I was like, I'm good on that. So we'll see if any others come through. And yeah, see you then. Okay, so another thing I noticed with Uber Eats is that it seems like you don't get the full amount right away. I think the tips have to come in later, it seems like, because it says I accepted that order for like $10 and change, but it says how much I made today was $4.07. But then I went into it because I'm like, okay, I know I accepted it for 10 bucks, so what do you mean? And it does say tips pending. So I don't know exactly how that works, how long it takes for it to not be pending. But it seems like it comes in later, the tips, and then that's where you hopefully get the full amount. I don't know. I like to get the money right away from what it says that I accepted it for. I feel like that's what I prefer. DoorDash, whatever money it says, that's the money you're going to see added to your overall balance for that day. But something that I've noticed as an FYI, yeah. All right, ciao. I'm back out, and we got another, sorry, I saw like a Party City order for DoorDash, but we got an order for Uber Eats, another Uber Eats order. Look at us go, Uber Eatsing out here for the first time. This is it here, about to head over now. It's getting a little dark out, it's 6 p.m., and it's getting darker sooner now that it's the end of September. You know, usually in the summer it stays light until like 8:30, but it's already getting a little dim out here. So yeah, so this Restaurants for Firehouse Subs is about 6 minutes away. So let's go. Ooh, it's about that traffic time. Alright you guys, by the way, you saw how it was raining earlier when I did my first order. Yeah, I had to be careful because my tires are not meant for rain right now. I try to do like a tire rotation, but my tires are so bald, two of them are so bald that I really have to be careful out here. So I'm back out and it's not really raining. What is this car doing? Anyways. There's some drops coming down, so I'm like getting nervous because I really should not be out here delivering in the rain with the tires that I have. But I am expecting to get new tires like beginning of next week because safety first, y'all. Safety first. I will spend the money for safety, okay? That is priceless. So, you know, I do have it, so gotta do it. Okay, so we just made it to Firehouse Subs. So it looks like they ordered two sandwiches. So let's go. Hello. You guys, so it's actually telling me that there's another order pickup for another restaurant that's in the same complex. I thought I was just picking up one order and one drop off. Am I bugging? Maybe I didn't read it correctly. Okay, apparently there's another order for Lotus Cafe. Oh, I see it. Okay. I don't know. Luckily, they're right next to each other, so let me get back out of the car and go to the Lotus Cafe. I don't know. I gotta look back at it. OMG, you guys, it's literally raining. Exactly what I did not want to happen. The forecast lied to me. No.
A few moments later.
Just what I did not want to happen. And I have two deliveries. I gotta be careful, y'all. It is really coming down right now. All right, so it's taking me to Minji first, 9 minutes away. So I'm gonna start heading over. Oh my God. And if you guys see my other vlog, I had just got my car, you know, done for the noise it was making with the muffler. Something was broken there. And whatever else, I can't remember exactly, but I had to get all that done. Now I gotta get at least two new tires. So let's go. Wish me luck. All right, so let's drop this off to Minji. We just got here. Okay, so the next jump off is 7 minutes away. So let's head there.
Drop off.
All right, so that one was a meet the customer. So he was approaching as soon as I was approaching. He was approaching the door, so perfect. Oh, more is coming up. $5 for 7.6 miles for Dairy Queen. Nah. All right, y'all, so I'm about to head home. And we'll see what happens tomorrow. See you there.
The next day.
All right, guys, it is the next day. Sorry for the quality. I am recording on my phone right now, but it's like 6:30 p.m. So I'll put the order here. $7 order for about 4.4 miles at Wendy's. And this order has 13 items. So it's probably gonna be like two large bags. But anyways, that's where I'm heading to now. And it's about 5 minutes away, so let's go.
A few moments later.
You guys, so I'm at the Wendy's. I go in, say that I arrived at the store to pick it up, walk in, and they say somebody else, another Dasher, already picked up the order. What? Like, so yeah. So basically I had to call customer service and they unsigned the order. And I was like, well, I already came all the way to the restaurant. Will I get any type of compensation for it at least coming all this way? So she said, yes. I think she said you'll get half the amount at least for going to the restaurant, because it wasn't my fault that something happened with DoorDash on their end. So she unassigned the order, said she'll pay me for at least half. And yeah. So at least I got something for it, at least. But like, what? All right, you guys. So I just picked up another order. It's actually for Crumbl cookies, which is funny because that has been the craze. So yes. So I'm about to head there. It's 5 minutes away. I got my SD card, so I'm back on my main camera. Yay. It is nighttime, dark now. It's 7 p.m. Gets dark so soon now that it's turning into the fall. But I'm just gonna do this order and then I'm done for the night, because they done tried me with that other order. I've actually heard of that happening to some other Dashers that I watch on YouTube, where it's not super often, but I've heard it happening. So where someone else picks up the order. Yeah. So anyways, let's get these Crumbl, these infamous Crumbl cookies. And yeah. Guys, it is so busy in this mall. It is a Friday night. I don't know where I'm gonna park. There's like no parking. I'm just trying to pick up some cookies, y'all. Come on now. I'm gonna just have to find a place and walk. I'm not about to be making a bunch of circles around this parking lot. Like, you guys. I literally had to walk across the whole parking lot just to get to the Crumbl cookies. OMG.
A few moments later.
You guys, that line is absolutely insane. I am not about to wait for that line. That's crazy. And I didn't catch it on camera, but they made an announcement saying the people in the back of the line, just know the wait is 2 to 3 hours. I would have been up and left. Sorry, I don't know if you can see my face because it's dark, but oh no, I would have been up and left. Like, it is absolutely insane. I'm not about to wait for the order. So I tried to call DoorDash. I wanted to just unassign it, but I wanted to see if I could still get paid because I came all the way up here. But they said if the wait is more than 10 minutes, then I can contact them and it won't affect me in any way. So I guess maybe I'll wait another couple of minutes and then call DoorDash again and see if I can get at least something for coming this way and waiting. And so now I know I'm never picking up another Crumbl cookie order again because this craze is absolutely ridiculous. Like, they're just cookies.
Give me a brief description of what I can help you with.
Order not ready.
Dashers who wait more than 10 minutes at the store are protected from low customer ratings and lateness contract violations. We can connect you with the merchant to get a revised estimate. Or, we can unassign you from the order. Would you like to be connected with Crumbl Cookies now?
No.
If you unassign now, you will not get paid for this order and your completion rate will be impacted. Would you still like to be unassigned?
Alright, so I'm calling customer service, but I'm going to go straight to a customer service rep instead of waiting for the automated because they keep giving me the runaround. Because I would like to get paid for this. At least something. Hi, I had a Dash pickup for Crumbl cookies, but the wait is way too long, and I've been here for longer than the 10 minutes. I want to unassign the order, but I want to see if there's any way I could get any compensation since I did wait the allotted time.
Okay, so I'll just quickly try calling the store and get this confirmed.
Okay. They're going to try to get in contact with the restaurant. Good luck with that.
Since I just tried calling the store multiple times and the store is not responding to the calls, and since it's taking a long time, I will just go ahead and cancel this order. You'll be able to receive an half pay, which will be updated in your earnings tab.
Good. I'm getting at least, what was it, $3 then for coming over here and just waiting. So at least I got paid for just standing in line for a little bit and waiting in my car. The drive was only 5 minutes away, so there we go. We made no deliveries tonight, but we got paid for an order that was already picked up by another Dasher and for a wait line that is absolutely ridiculously too long, and I don't think anybody's gonna be picking up that order tonight. So sorry whoever ordered them Crumbl cookies, but you're just gonna have to go up to the store yourself and wait 3 hours like everyone else apparently. Anyways, I'll see y'all tomorrow. I gotta come back out so I can show y'all at least some delivery, like, but yeah, see y'all. Hey guys, so it is the next day and we are back out from the craziness of last night trying to get that order from Crumbl cookies. So I don't know. So I went on Uber Eats and just got an order. So I put the order up here. So it's pretty good, $11 for about 4.6 miles to drop-offs, I believe. So I'm about to head to the restaurant now. It is 5 minutes away. But yeah, you guys, and the craziness kind of continues because I want to show you guys a couple of screenshots from some orders that came in for Crumbl cookies and how much they were trying to offer. Like, look at look at this other one. And then the big one, like $80 to deliver Crumbl cookies. That
is insane. I literally saw three, like the ones I just showed you, and I had just got on the app and I saw three come up offering between $70 to $80 to pick up some Flippin' Crumbl cookies and deliver them. And I'm like, nobody must be taking those orders because that's why it's so much. I've never seen a payout that high on any delivery, like service type thing that I've done, at least. So it's crazy out here. This craze is getting out of hand. Anyways, it is raining a little bit right now. So like I said, gotta be careful. Guys, I am so confused. The GPS was supposed to be taking me to PF Chang's, the restaurant, but when it told me the destination's on the right, there was just an Applebee's there, and I'm like, this is not PF Chang's. So then I ended up driving past, so now I'm just gonna put it in my Google Maps because I am so confused. Where is the PF Chang's? Oh my god, this is so annoying. So now it's basically having me do like a whole U-turn in this traffic out here.
In 800 feet, turn left to stay on Romer Avenue.
Oh my god, what is going on? I can't even get over there. Ugh. I'll be back. Okay, so come to find out, the PF Chang's is actually in the mall. So it was not taking me to the correct location. It had me completely drive past it, saying my destination was on the right after I've already passed the area.
Get to your pickup at PF Chang's.
Like, what the heck? I had to Google it to find out where's the actual location, because where Uber's GPS is taking me is not where it's located. Like, I'm so confused. And it's still saying it's over here, and that's not true. Oh my god, this is so bad. Oh my god, I can't believe Uber took me to the wrong place, navigated me to the wrong place. That's crazy. That is not okay. There's the actual PF Chang's location, not wherever the heck Uber was trying to send me.
A few moments later.
All right, we got that first order. Oh my gosh, that was so flippin' annoying. All right, so now it's taking me to Applebee's for the second pickup. So there's two restaurants and two drop-offs. I wish the app was a little bit more clear on the description, because it says like delivery and I'll say two, but it doesn't tell you if it's the same restaurant or two different restaurants. You know, let's head to Applebee's. I know where that is because that's where they kept trying to send me far past that way. So let's go there. By the way, the Crumbl cookie order that I took yesterday was from DoorDash. And now Uber Eats is offering, but they're trying to like hike the price up so somebody can actually take it. So it was two different platforms that had the situation with Crumbl cookies going on. I wonder if DoorDash is now offering that much money for Crumbl cookies like Uber Eats is. All right, got the Applebee's order. So it's navigating me first to the Applebee's order, which is 6 minutes away. All right, so we just dropped off the first one. I didn't really record it because I'm just trying to get it done. But now we're going to the second drop off for the PF Chang's order. So I hope they're not too upset because I was running around trying to figure out where Uber Eats is trying to take me. All right, I'm back. I went around to the wrong side of the building, but there's like businesses on one side and then apartments where you go up to the top and they live above the businesses that are in the front. So I went to the front. So I called her. She told me just to come around the back and we made contact. I found her. So those deliveries have been complete. Here's the amount I got for those. And I am going home. All right, guys. So we're gonna end this video here. The craziness of this video as well. It started out pretty fair and then the end, I don't know what happened there, but anyways, hope you guys enjoyed it at least. But yeah, so let's do the total. So we did three Uber Eats deliveries, two of which were two pickups and deliveries, and then two DoorDash attempts but they did pay us half for the amount of money that they were supposed to pay us out. So I'll put the total that we got here, and it looks like we reached our goal of reaching our last 100. So that's so exciting. We finally made it there. So yeah, so we did the full 300 that I originally started this entire dashing series to earn, and we made it. We had it tonight, so yay. But anyways, guys, I do have an upcoming vacation. If you guys saw my Temu try on vlog, you'll see that I will be going to Cancun, Mexico. So I'll still be out here doing some dashes, because any little amount would definitely help right now and towards that vacation as well. So yeah, guys, if you guys enjoyed this video, definitely subscribe, like the video, comment on the craziness and this Crumbl cookie phase. Let me know if you've tried them, or like if you think this craze is just going overboard, if it's happening in your area too, like OMG. But anyways, guys, thanks so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.